Welcome to Year of Jacksonville Class 10 graduation. We appreciate you being early, and we will get started in just a moment. Remember, you're in listen-only mode, so you will not be able to be on screen, but you should be able to see all the fun and celebrate right along with us online. This is also being broadcast on Facebook Live, so you will be able to watch there as well if you have any technical difficulties with joining the webinar or staying in the webinar. Thank you so much. We appreciate your support of our graduates.
Thank you. That's one of my favorite songs. Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us to celebrate a great milestone during a very difficult and challenging time. I wish we could all be together physically. I'm Morris Applewhite, and I'm honored and delighted to serve as Managing Director for YearUp's national office. At YearUp, we believe every young adult has potential and deserves opportunity and economic justice. On behalf of our entire organization, we welcome each and every one of you to celebrate the YearUp Jacksonville Class of July 2020, our 10th graduating class here in Jacksonville, Florida. This impressive group of young adults have stayed the course and made it through an extremely rigorous program. I speak for the entire staff when I say we are very proud of you, graduates, for your achievements over this past year. And we all gather together, although it be virtually, on this very special evening to lift you up, to celebrate you, and recognize your accomplishments. So this is a very special occasion as we pay tribute to YearUp Jacksonville Class 10. And it is especially rewarding as we continue the fight for racial and economic justice in our country. Recent events have served to shine a bright light on the injustices that continue. As I speak with CEOs and senior executives of corporate America, which I was a part of for some 30 years, I tell them that expectations are very high, that corporations will take on a more aggressive and bolder stance to be more inclusive in their human capital practices. And in doing so, will recognize the significant value and contribution that all of you can make to their company's success. As you may be aware, there are nearly 5 million young adults that are disconnected, unemployed, or not in school in the United States. There are 200,000 young adults that are disconnected in Florida alone. YearUp serves as a launching pad to provide opportunity to young adults and arm them with the technical and professional skills to be successful in corporate America. We level the playing field so they have a shot at getting connected to the economic mainstream and earn livable wages that will provide a secure financial future for themselves and for their families. Graduates, you have gone through 6 months of learning and development in the classroom and 6 months of internship to earn your right to be here this evening. As I reflect on where you are in your journey, graduates, I'm reminded of a quote: "There is no passion to be found in playing small, in settling for a life that is less than one you are capable of living." Words of a great man, Mr. Nelson Mandela. You have all demonstrated that you are capable and talented, and I know that you will not settle. You will make a mark, and you will forge ahead to realize your dreams and maximize your full potential. I would like to take a moment to shout out to some special people in the audience. We all stand on someone's shoulders. So first of all, to the families and friends of the graduates that are in attendance, we welcome you and we recognize you for the support you have provided to these graduates. Let's give it up for the families and friends with a virtual round of applause. Job well done. We would like to give a special welcome to our advisory board of directors that are with us this evening. I would like to personally thank them for their service and support. We also welcome Dr. Marie Nagy of Florida State College of Jacksonville. And certainly want to welcome our dynamic keynote speaker this evening, Justin Pearson, Special Assistant to the Chief Executive Officer at YearUp. Now, as I pass the baton to our Jacksonville team, a quick reminder to our graduates: grab the graduation box that you should have recently received in the mail Have it ready to open, but not just yet. So with that, I'll pass it to Kiara.
Thank you, Morris. Europe's mission is to close the opportunity divide by ensuring that young adults gain the skills, experiences, and support that will empower them to reach their potential through career and higher education. As we could not fulfill that mission without the support of national and local sponsors and partners. We'd like to thank our local internship partners listed here who have provided opportunities for our graduates. We thank our national sponsors listed here who financially support Europe graduation celebrations across the United States. We also recognize our national community partners who enrich the experiences of our students. Finally, we say thank you to 7 people who continue to make a difference in the lives of young adults in Jacksonville. Our local advisory board members, chaired by Ms. Susan Turchin, you are deeply appreciated. For those of you who joined us online and are new to Europe, here's a glimpse into what it takes to be a Europe student.
You know, you'll have to be fully committed. It's not going to be easy. There's no halfway to this. Are you willing to put the work in?
You can probably guess what happens here. I said yes. We all did. But there's something not so obvious, not even to us, at the time. All that work ahead. Will it be worth it? Orientation. Met the Europe staff and my classmates. That's Emmanuel, Stephanie, Mike, and that's Janine. I learned the rules. Don't be late, go all out, stay hungry. Easy enough. 2 weeks in, first presentation. I could use a little more practice, and will. I'll kill it next time. We built a computer today. Who knew I could do that? Now, my mentor does. Pop quiz. Nothing like being prepared. Plus, Eric's my study partner. Got an A. Next time, A+. Group projects begin. With extra shifts at work, gotta find the time. But if there's a will, you know the rest. Group meeting. Presentation day. Killed it. Studying. Final exams. And just like that, classes are finished. I'm out. Internships begin. Where you off to?
U.S. Trust, Bank of America.
Citizens Bank.
Ocean State Job Lot.
CVS Health.
Neighborhood Health Plan. And you?
Lifespan. Oh, shoot. Gotta go.
As an intern here, your success will depend on the work you put in.
Let's do this. Responsibilities increasing. The work doesn't stop. The life of a young professional. One-on-one with my supervisor. He's dependent on me, so I'm putting in work. Extra hours to stay ahead. Joe from Year Up suggested tweets on my resume. Wait, what? Apply to 50 places? All right, I'm on it. Internship, second job, home at midnight. Head down, but not for long. Get up, coffee, intern, eat, work, work. The next day, do it again. Suit and tie is on, so is my game face. Mock interviews at Year Up. Practice makes perfect. Showtime. Internship done. Graduation. You've heard the saying worth the wait, but rather than waiting, I went to work. 735 hours of classes, 1,040 hours of interning with one of Europe's corporate partners. That's 1,775 hours of putting in the work. So, was it all worth it? I'll let you be the judge of that. As for me, I have to get to work. First day at my new job. Can't be late.
Our keynote speaker this afternoon is Justin J. Pearson. He is the fourth son of 5 boys born to teenage parents in Memphis, Tennessee. Justin J. graduated from Mitchell High School as valedictorian and Bowdoin College in 2017, majoring in government and legal studies and education studies. He currently lives in Memphis and provides remote support to Europe headquarters in Boston, Massachusetts, ready for the day that operations return to an in-person on-site status. Justin J. Pearson has an unwavering commitment to justice and the pursuit of opportunity for all people. As special assistant to the CEO of Europe, his focus remains on social, racial, and economic justice, and he leverages that passion for justice every day in support of 18 to 24-year-olds enrolled in Europe. As the founder of a Memphis-based academic enrichment program called Camp Hope Memphis, he regularly provides enrichment and opportunity for high schoolers across Memphis. Europe Jacksonville is proud to welcome Justin J. Pearson.
Kiara, thank you so much for that kind introduction. I appreciate it, and I appreciate the opportunity to be here with all of you. It is so wonderful to see friends and so many familiar faces as well. To Sherry, who has put on this event and helped coordinate so meticulous of planning, thank you. To LaTanya for the opportunity and for leading this beautiful array of graduates to this point. Congratulations and thank you. To this wonderful team, you're up. You are extraordinary, and I am grateful to work alongside you and with you as we do the work of closing the opportunity divide in this country. We are here at this moment to both honor and celebrate you all. You have done a tremendous job. You've accomplished what some people might have thought not possible. You have committed hours upon hours to a cause greater than yourself, but also to the benefit of yourself, your community, and your family. We're here to celebrate you, and we are here to commence to provide a beginning on a journey that you all have endeavored to take on. We're here at this moment, though, during a pretty unexpected and unparalleled and unprecedented time. All of us, we're sitting in kitchens, on couches, in living rooms across Jacksonville, and even from across the country. We did not choose for a global pandemic of COVID-19 to put us all in these different places and separate us in this way and find new ways to interact as we are doing this graduation. And as we celebrate, we have to recognize the moment we're in our nation's history, this nation, this United States of America, built on the genocide of indigenous nations, of kidnapped, enslaved, raped, battered, and abused Black people. This nation is losing its ability to remain within the walls of complacency of a status quo that didn't work for people like us. Yes, we are here to celebrate your job well done, your fight well earned, and we have a daunting task and reality of which each of us are currently a part. See, today, more than 60,000 people will contract the COVID-19 disease. Today, we are living in a time with the greatest economic inequality in our nation's history. In fact, if we just look at Jacksonville in particular, 25% of our kids are in poverty. The average Black income is about $20,000 less than the average white folks' income. 16% of the people are in poverty, and if you really look deeper for African Americans, that's about 25%. And for Hispanic folks, that's about 20%. We are in a difficult time in our cities and in our country. See, we have seen the public lynchings of people like Mr. George Floyd and Miss Breonna Taylor and Ahmaud Arbery. We are in an unprecedented time in our nation's history as we reckon with the reality of injustice. But I believe we must face this reality if we are to change it. And we are at a point with a crucible, with this class in particular, a crucible between hope and hopelessness. And people might ask, how can you have hope and where do you find hope when your communities are being the most disinvested in? Where can you find hope and where is there hope when there's inequality that is so pervasive? And you turn on the news and you continue to see the battering again and again of systems of injustice. Where do you go? Well, I'm so fortunate that I'm here with you this evening, because I can go to this room, to our virtual space together, and find hope. See, I find hope in Roman. He had an uphill battle to be a part of this class and to graduate today. It didn't look so great the last time that he was in the program. It was an uphill battle then, and made a tough decision that, you know what, I'm going to come back. I'm going to come back, and I'm going to give it another try, because I believe I have the intrinsic ability to overcome obstacles. And so that's what happened. Roman came back, and I'm so excited to say that not only did he come back and achieve in learning and development, but also at internship, and is now being converted into a full-time role with Merrill Client and Account Services. See, these are the places where I find hope amidst the tidal waves of injustice. I think of Luke Von Traham, another member of this class, and Karita Aluma. During L&D, they gave it their best, but they were struggling a little bit toward the end with low points in our contract. But through perseverance and extreme amounts of coaching and support from their community and the people who are sitting next to them, they are now going to be hired at Bank of America in the IT department. See, when the walls of injustice seem to be closing in, we don't have to go far beyond our virtual room right here at this graduation to find hope to persevere forward. See, I even think about Haley Harris. See, Haley was in the program and was pregnant, got pregnant during the program, and had the choice, and the team here gave her the choice to say, hey, if you're not wanting to continue, you can stop. We'll figure out a way for you to come back. And Haley said, no, I think I've got what it takes to persevere. I think I've got what it takes to make it to the end of this thing. And so I'm just going to push on, and I'm just going to push forward. And Haley had a child during her internship, and only 2 weeks later returned back to internship and said, I'm going to go all the way, just 2 weeks after giving birth. See, these stories remind me of a history that each of us are a part of. See, it's a history of ancestors who persevered through difficult circumstances to get us here. There are people who persevered beyond what people said they could do in order that we might have an opportunity to gather, to celebrate, and to take ownership of the work that we have left undone. If you are a descendant of enslaved people, you can understand that even through the difficulties of today, we've seen something like this, and we've overcome it. We were enslaved for 246 years, and we're still here. If you are a Latino American, and you have seen the tragedies happening at our borders, and still you are here. If you're of Asian descent, you will remember Korosu and a country that enslaved Asian Americans, and they fought for freedom, and they fought for reparations, and you are still here. See, we have seen the difficulties of today before. And there is something so powerful and so magnificent of being able to find hope just here in this room. Not with perfect people, but with people who have chosen that despite all of the odds to persevere. That is who you are. That is the challenge you took on, and that is what we are celebrating today. And we know that the work is still to be done. And the hope that I have, and I know so many other folks, some of the folks sitting right next to you, your parents and your siblings who are so proud of you, that the hope they have is that the power that you are now ascertaining in this paper that you will receive in a certificate for a job well done comes with the responsibility to use that power to empower others. It is to use power to make a change for something better. This is the moment we are in. So as I stand here, I believe more faithfully and more hopefully than I ever have that with you holding the power, with you tapping into the responsibility that comes with it, our future is better. In fact, I'd go so far as to say I have an infinite hope in what is coming next for each and every one of you, and also for us as a community and us as a country. Because you realize, as many other folks are starting to realize, that we are in a battle and we are in a war that we really cannot lose. See, we cannot lose against the systems that seek to oppress us. We have fought through those. You fought through those when you applied to this program. You fought through those every day that you woke up in order to make it to internship on time. You have fought through the things that would otherwise stop us. And so I'm confident that we will win. I'm confident that we will win because I see and I know you. We will win against the systems that tell us that a dedicated minority of people who are creative dissenters, as Dr. King might have said, can't change the course of history. We'll win because we believe that there is something better and more possible in this union we call the United States of America. I believe that we will win because we have been persistent in the streets for protest against police brutality and against racism. I believe that we will win because you are the hope for tomorrow. I believe that we will win because you have given it your best and you are continuing to give it your all. I believe that we will win because the shackles of injustice are being broken slowly but surely by this group of people committed to a cause greater than themselves. I believe that we will win because we cannot lose. We can't lose because we remember the people in chains centuries ago, and we remember those who are locked in prisons today in rural areas across the country. We will win because we will stand up against the systems of poverty that have incarcerated 140 million people. We will win because we believe that there is something more powerful and something greater and something better beyond systems of oppression. And I am more hopeful and I am more faithful now than I have ever been because the graduates of Year of Jacksonville this year are going out into the world with a renewed sense of possibility and promise. I thank you. I bless you on this journey, and I look forward to being a part of this movement with you. God bless you. God bless Jacksonville and our country too. Thank you.
Justin, I want to thank you for your message. Certainly words we're all going to carry with us in the coming weeks, months, and even years. So thank you. My name is Vivian Robarts, and I am the corporate engagement leader for the region of Florida. The Corporate Commitment Award recognizes partners with a steadfast commitment to providing long-term support for students of the Europe program. Today, I'm excited as we honor an employer of influence that demonstrates an incredible level of commitment to Europe and our students, and that's FIS Global. We could not do what we do at Europe without the support of individuals and companies like FIS. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Vivian. My name is Travis Smith. I'm a director of corporate engagement here in Jacksonville, and I have the pleasure of announcing another award that we're giving out. This is called the Bridges Award. This recognition honors an organization or an individual who has gone above and beyond to connect Europe Jacksonville with community leaders, influencers, prospects, and the next great opportunity. This award also recognizes a willingness to influence, leverage, connect, resource, and build relationships to better spread awareness of Europe here in Jacksonville. And today, we're honoring Joseph Crawford of the First Coast YMCA. Thank you so much, Joe, and thank you to everyone at the Y who works towards closing the opportunity divide here in Northeast Florida.
Good afternoon. I'm Ayana Nelson, Employment Placement Manager for Europe Jacksonville. Now, it gives me great pleasure to acknowledge that 29 of our graduates have maintained a 3.0 GPA in pursuit of a college degree. And two members of class 10 have achieved a 4.0, Katoya Belton and Jean Resnick. We are so proud of these 29 scholars. In addition to celebrating our academic scholars, we will now recognize graduates who have not only persisted through the Europe program, but also persisted to obtain a college degree or education with our education partner, Florida State College at Jacksonville. So I welcome our next guest speaker, Dr. Marie Foster Nagy, Vice President for Institutional Effectiveness and Advancement at FSCJ.
Greetings to everyone. On behalf of our president, Dr. John Avendano, and the faculty and staff of our college, Florida State College at Jacksonville, congratulations, Europe graduates. Graduation looks a little different this year, but the meaning and intent is still the same, to celebrate you. There are moments in our lives where we want to high-five everyone. I'm sure that this is one of those moments for you and your parents, siblings and extended family, friends, teachers, mentors, coaches, and internship partners. Certainly, there is no other class that can claim to have overcome the adverse conditions that you have. Those challenges may have left literal and figurative scars, but you've made it. I describe you as resilient. Whether you were on internship or taking class or both, you demonstrated your resolve to successfully complete the certificate you will be awarded here today. Some of you may even be completing associate's and bachelor's degrees or making progress in that direction, as some of you have completed your program while also balancing family responsibilities. Maya Angelou said, "I can be changed by what happens to me, but I refuse to be reduced by it." Resilience is our ability to adapt and bounce back when things don't go as planned. The resilient person does not wallow or dwell on the negatives or the challenges. They adjust, adapt, apply new strategies, and move forward. You've learned a great lesson in your experiences these last few months, and while no one would have wished them on you, the lessons will stand you in great stead. You've learned that each difficulty is a challenge and not something that will stop you in your tracks. You stayed committed to your goals, and you got out of bed each morning and worked on achieving your dream of being a graduate of this program. Having a great job, a vocation in life, and continuing your education to your degree. You understood what you could control, your learning and completion of this program, and you were empowered and confident. You put your effort where it could have the greatest impact. You were committed to your goals and the pursuit of your dreams. As resilient persons, you know that you are the only ones with the power and responsibility to find the diamonds when life is throwing you stones. Stay resilient, and while being so, make a positive difference in your life and the lives of others. I hope your dreams take you to the corners of your smiles, to the highest of your hopes, to the windows of your opportunities, and to the most special places your heart has ever known. Congratulations. And now it gives me great pleasure to recognize the 13 graduates who have obtained or are within 18 semester hours of earning an associate degree. Andrea Anderson, Alyssa Flakowitz, Christelle Florestal, Brandon Jefferson, Issa Nubani, Karita Aloma, Liana Powell, Hannah Ray, Alec Sotomayor, Lukman Trainum, Emmanuel Villanueva, Nakira Wesley, and Kamala Williams.
Now we move on to an award that is central to Europe culture, our Core Values Award. As program managers, you've had the honor of teaching, instilling, and modeling these core values. Respect and value others. Build trust and be honest. Strive to learn. Be accountable. Engage and embrace diversity. And finally, work hard and have fun. Representing the blue chip learning community, the graduate who's best exemplified how to respect and value others is Yuvaline Thermius. The graduate who best exemplifies how to build trust and be honest, Vong VP Piang. The graduate who embodies strive to learn is Jamari Ingram. The graduate who best exemplifies how to be accountable, Issa Nubani. The graduate who best exemplifies how to engage and embrace diversity is Julia Rodriguez. And last but not least, the one who knows how to work hard and have fun, Alyssa Flakowitz.
Representing the Gold Standard Learning Community, the graduate who best exemplifies how to respect and value others is Jacob Anderson. The graduate who best exemplifies how to build trust and be honest is Kayla Young. The graduate who embodies strive to learn is Kevon Bryant. The graduate who best exemplifies how to be accountable is Kush Shikari. The graduate who best exemplifies how to engage and embrace diversity is Charlotte Smith. And last, but certainly not least, the gold standard student who knows best how to work hard and have fun is Daron Argret. Congratulations to all of you, and thank you for leading our organization in upholding these core values.
Good afternoon. I am Stephanie M. Jackson, Student Services Manager for Europe Jacksonville. It has been my extreme privilege to work with these graduates and to ensure they have the highest support possible. With that high support comes high expectations. And that's what this next award is all about, the Cedric I. Cruz Award for Perseverance. We give this award in memory of an inaugural staff member of Europe Jacksonville, someone who was there from the very Mr. Cedric Cruz. His life was a testament to courage, selflessness, and advocacy. He greatly admired young adults who displayed grit and perseverance in the face of difficult obstacles. So it is my privilege to recognize two graduates who demonstrate these qualities while pursuing opportunity with the fierce courage and passion. The Cedric I. Cruz Award goes to Roman Lampkin and Christian Johnson. Congratulations to you both.
Hi, everyone. I'm Ellen Ong, Director of Corporate Engagement for Europe Jacksonville. I have the privilege of seeing the Class 10 recipients of the David Rettig Award for Excellence. David Rettig held incredibly high standards for himself and had a special talent for inspiring others to excel. Before his untimely death during tragedy, Dave consistently pursued excellence and encouraged others to do the same. The David Rettig Award for Excellence honors graduates for their commitment to both the Europe program and their local community. These graduates have served as outstanding ambassadors of Europe and demonstrated personal excellence. 10, the David Rettig Award for Excellence goes to Katoya Belton and Brenton Lester. Congratulations to both of you. And now we invite our site director, LaTanya Hines, to announce the Chris Mello Awards for Leadership.
Throughout his life, Chris Mello was a leader and a waymaker. Both on and off the sports field, Chris quietly established himself as an exceptional leader. He led with his actions, commitment, work ethic, and integrity. The Chris Mello Award for Leadership recognizes graduates whose persistence and determination paved the way to seizing opportunity in the midst of extreme adversity. Class 10, it is my privilege to recognize two of your classmates. The Chris Mello Award for Leadership goes to Janiyah Wheeler and Malcolm Smith. And being the leaders that they are, we have asked Janiyah and Malcolm to give brief remarks. Janiyah.
Thank you, God. Thank you, Europe staff. Thank you, family and friends. What do you want to be when you grow up? What career do you want to have? Where do you see yourself in the future? I don't know if I'm the only one who has realized it, but the closer we become to graduating, the more anxious I feel about the next steps. Europe class of 2020, here we are, about to take the next step into adulthood. Some of us are walking away today with a job opportunity, and many are walking away with newly acquired knowledge and experience. As frustrating as this season of our lives may have been, hold this phrase near and dear in your heart. Everything happens for a reason. Leaders are made through adversity. Some of us are still uncertain about that next step, who we want to become, where we will go from here, and pressure from peers and family or the world around us does not make that decision any easier. Initially, I didn't know what I should say to you today. However, when I began writing, the words just flowed onto the paper. The older we get, every decision becomes more vital. It often feels like playing chess. One wrong move and game over. It's not supposed to be this way. The truth is, history would have us living in fear, afraid to fail, afraid to take a risk, afraid to dream. Doubt kills more dreams than failure, but history has no hold on our future. Class 10. So we will dream big, take risks, fail, get up again, and dream some more. Thank you.
That was awesome, Janiyah. Thank you so much. Malcolm?
First, I'd like to thank God. We wouldn't be here without him. Secondly, I'd like to thank the Europe staff for choosing me to be the blue chip recipient of this award. Lastly, I'd like to thank all the parents, siblings, coaches, friends, and others who have helped Class 10 in persisting through this program. When I first found out that I would be receiving this award and would share a few words with you all, I didn't know where to start. I began to think about ways I could be considered a leader. The one thing I kept returning to is how we all are leaders. We entered this journey as strangers. Many of us were very introverted and didn't feel comfortable enough to have a casual conversation with peers in our coaching group. Now we are one big family. The first bonding experience I remember from the beginning of L&D included taking a marker and writing a negative word that people have used to describe us at any point in our life. I felt that that was a very sensitive topic, but for the first time, I felt as if we were all connected. My fellow graduates, think about that word you wrote. Having the title Year Up Alumni shows you are the exact opposite of that word. You had the persistence to stay the course when times got tough. I know we all face challenging obstacles inside and outside of Europe. For example, the first career readiness assessment. I've never heard the phrase figure it out as much as I did that day. And yes, I'm talking about Michael Williams. That day taught me a vital lesson. I learned that self-sufficiency is key for success. Throughout this journey, we learned lessons. Most importantly, we learned how to become the young professionals we are today. So I come to you as a leader, speaking to other leaders. And I leave you with this thought. This is not the end. The struggle is not over. Without struggle, there's no growth. And without growth, there's no success. Today is only the beginning. Thank you.
Thank you, Malcolm. And now the part that we've all been waiting for. Recognition of our Class 10 graduates.
Come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm.
That as a member of the Year Up National Alumni Association.
I pledge
that as a member of the Year Up National Alumni Association,
I will continue to uphold and promote Year Up's mission and core values.
I pledge that as a member of the Year Up National Alumni Association, I will continue to uphold and promote Year Up's mission and core values.
I will continue to uphold and promote Year Up's mission and core values.
I will continue to uphold and promote Europe's mission and core values.
I will continue to uphold and promote Europe's mission and core values.
Europe's mission and core values.
I will strive for excellence and realize my potential.
I will strive for excellence and realize my potential.
I will strive for excellence and realize.
I will strive for excellence and realize my potential.
I will strive for excellence and realize my potential.
And realize my potential.
I will use my time and talents.
I will use my time and talents to contribute.
I will use my time and talents to contribute to the success of Europe.
I will use my time and talents to contribute to the success of Europe, its students, and its alumni.
Its students and its alumni.
I will take action.
I will take action in the movement.
I will take action in the movement.
I will take action in the movement to close the opportunity divide.
I will take action in the movement to close the opportunity divide.
Close the opportunity divide.
To close the opportunity divide.
I will take action in the movement to close the opportunity divide.
I will take action in the movement to close the opportunity divide. I take this oath freely.
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 I take this oath freely as I promise to lift.
To lift while I climb.
To lift while I climb.
To lift while I climb.
As I promise to lift while I climb and to be a lifelong ambassador of Europe.
As I promise to lift while I climb and to be a lifelong ambassador of Europe.
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 A lifelong ambassador of Europe.
And to be a lifelong ambassador of Europe. Thank you.
All right, you ready?
Okay.
And I'm recording the whole thing.
I know I'm gonna mess up, it's cool.
Yeah. All right, I pledge that as a member of the Europe, no.
Okay, I can't, like, you want me to say it now?
Aloha. Can y'all hear me?
Aloha.
The strive for accident to realize my potential.
Emmanuel.
Did you just bust out and start laughing? Come on, girl.
I'm sorry.
Why is my video turned off?
Girl, please.
Can I go out there, Alyssa?
Yeah, that's fine, Aaron.
Okay. I mean, I'll try.
Stop. Please stop.
As we close this inspiring time together, I want to leave you with just a few thoughts, and then you can move on with your own celebration plans for the evening. Congratulations to our graduates and award recipients. Thank you to all of our speakers. And Justin Pearson, thank you, thank you, thank you. Our amazing college partner, FSCJ, Florida State College, Jacksonville, Dr. Avendano, Dr. Nagy, we appreciate you so much. And the mighty Year Up Jacksonville team. I love and appreciate you all. Year Up is made possible primarily by our amazing students, our college partner, our corporate partners, and our dedicated team. We would not be able to achieve the vision of Year Up, a future where every young adult will be able to reach their full potential without the support of our board, alumni, donors, volunteers, elected officials, and the community at large. Class 10, as you make your way into the world, we recognize you have pursued and obtained this opportunity in order to get a good career and provide for yourself and your family. Don't settle for mediocrity. Commit yourself to excellence in everything that you do. Always remember that professional success and personal growth require more than knowledge and talent. You must continue to embody our core values, be accountable, respect and value others, build trust, be honest, engage and embrace diversity, strive to learn, and my personal favorite, work hard and have fun. Because character matters, and so does heart. To arrive at this destination, you've overcome obstacles. I mean, you made it through your internship in the middle of a pandemic. And there will be some challenges and disappointments in the days ahead, but never forget your why. The why that brought you here. Continue to pursue your why with passion and with courage. We believe in a better future, a world that is more peaceful and just. We believe in a bright future because we believe in you. You are our hope. It depends on you. Graduates, Class 10, the entire Year Up Jacksonville staff and I remain committed to you and your success. Godspeed. Thank you everyone for joining us, and this concludes our program.
The C is for the courage I possess through the drama. H is for the hurt, but it's all for the honor. A is for my attitude, working through the patience. Money comes and goes, so the M is for motivation. Gotta stay consistent, the P is to persevere. The I is for integrity, innovative career. The O is optimistic, open and never shut. And the N is necessary, cause I'm never giving up. See, they ask me how I did it, I just did it from the heart. Crushing the competition, been doing it from the start. They say that every champion is all about his principles. Carry. Bye.